What's up, everybody? I hope everyone's tank is doing great, and this is the first episode of Nano News. For these sets of videos, I'm going to be primarily focusing on nano reef related topics. In these videos, I'm going to showcase articles, pictures, videos, just any cool stuff that I find during the week that, you know, relates to the reefing hobby. I want to showcase new products that I find that would be awesome for nano tanks. And also, at the end of every video, I'm going to be doing a section called FTS of the Week, where you guys can send me your FTSs, and from the pictures that you send me, I'll decide my favorite every week. And at the end of every video, I'll have a little segment that'll show your full tank shot, give a little description about your tank, show some more pictures and stuff like that. And if you want to be in the FTS of the Week, just give me a link to your FTS in the comment section below, and then I'll choose my favorite. Well, the first product that I saw this week that caught my eye was the Reef Tap, and it's a new type of frag plug that screws directly into live rock. And I think the Reef Tap is a great idea, and it will eliminate a lot of mess associated with fragging and gluing corals, because you basically just find a hole in your rock, jab the Reef Tap in it, then screw it in. The frag plug is made out of ceramic, and it has a rough surface that will basically just assist in coral growth. And right now they're available at reeftap.com for 75 cents each, and I'm definitely thinking about buying some. This next product is definitely one of my favorite things that I've come across this week, and it is the Oceanlife Overflow. There's nothing really fancy about it, except that it is very minimal and it won't take away from your aquarium like normal overflows. Because the one that I have in my tank is extremely bulky and it just kind of sticks out. Basically, this thing has a small strainer on the overflow and an air hole that's drilled into the top, which is pretty standard. All of that will allow for the drain to operate properly and work quietly. But the sad thing is, the overflow system is only available in Europe right now. But whenever this thing comes out, I definitely want to replace my current setup. Okay, here's a product that I definitely plan on purchasing. It is made by Vertex Aquaristik, and they made two magnetic cleaners and a really nice probe holder. The two magnetic cleaners are basically really nice algae scrubbers that are made out of titanium, and one of them is round and the other one's rectangular. Once I find a place to order this thing, I'm going to do a review of it because I'm kind of desperate. I can't even stick my hand in my tank without my clownfish attacking me, so this would basically be perfect for me. Here's an awesome video that I found that showcases Blue World Aquarium's Xbox 360 Nano Reef. The team over at Blue World Aquariums purchased a broken Xbox 360 and converted it into a nice little Nano Reef. The Xbox holds a little under a gallon of water and is plumbed directly into an external canister filter. For lighting, they use an LED strip that is controlled using a wireless remote. The tank has absolutely no live rock because of how thin it actually is, so they had to actually attach the corals onto a piece of acrylic using epoxy. Now it's time for the FTS of the week. This week's full tank shot is of South Florida Tron's 23.5-gallon Starfire Rimless Reef. He submitted his FTS on the Nano Reef forums. His tank is lit by an aqua illumination soul blue, and it is packed with tons of ORA SPS. This is definitely one inspirational Nano Reef. Well, that's it for the first episode of Nano News. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you're automatically notified every time I make a new video. Happy reefing!